Running. Launch commit. Liftoff. We have liftoff 49 minutes past the hour.
The only moon-bound Saturn V to blast off from Launch Pad 39B carried a crew of astronauts who had to do everything the later Apollo 11 crew had to do. Everything but land. Everything but get the glory. Tom Stafford, now of Brevard County, John Young of Orlando, and Gene Cernan had nicknamed their Apollo spacecraft Charlie Brown and their moon lander Snoopy.
Boy, this is really a rugged planet.
Their job was to get within about 8 miles of the moon's surface.
That's going to be a real kick tomorrow down at 50,000 feet.
And it did sound like fun when they got there.
Houston, this is Snoopy.
Right, Snoop, go ahead.
We is going, we is down among them, Charlie.
Roger, I hear you weaving your way up the freeway.
But don't forget, a moon lander is also a launcher, just like this one from Apollo 17. The Apollo 10 crew had to do this in mid-flight, 8 miles above the surface. And when they did, their return pod, Snoopy, went into a spin. It came within a few revolutions of going out of control and crashing back onto the moon. But they got Snoopy back under control, returned to the mothership, Charlie Brown, and lived to tell about it. 50 years ago, this week. There are those who say Apollo 10 was more risky than Apollo 11, the moon landing. And those who took that risk deserve to be remembered. On the Space Coast, Dan Billow, WESH 2 News.